Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It is about understanding. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about relation among the chords of a circle. What are the objectives among the chords of the circle? First, we will determine the relation among the chords of a circle. Second, we will find the measure among the chords of a circle. What could be the relation among the chords of the circle? The diameter is the longest chord of a circle. The diameter of the circle is twice its radius. So as you can see, the segment AB is radius and segment BC is the radius. And then segment AC is considered as the diameter. So it means diameter is equal twice the radius. What if we need to identify the radii of the circle? The radii of the circle are congruent. So as you can see, segment AB is congruent to segment BC. So what could be the formula for the radius? The radius is half of the diameter. Segment AC is the diameter, and then BC, twice of the radius, is the diameter. And half of the diameter, that is the radius. Segment XY and segment YZ is the radius. The perpendicular bisector of a chord passes through the center of the circle. So segment XZ is a chord that passes through the center of the circle. So as you can see, this is perpendicular bisector. What could be the formula to identify this triangle? So the formula to be used to identify the triangle, that is C squared, is equal to A squared plus B squared. C is the hypotenuse, and then A and B is the legs. In circle B, segment BC is perpendicular to segment AR. So this is segment BC is perpendicular to segment AR. So let us solve. Let us find the following. Number one, if segment GR is equal to 18, so this is 18, let us identify the segment AG and segment AR. So nasaan yon? So this is segment AG and then segment AR. So what could be the formula to identify the segment AG and AR? Since BC, so this is BC, is perpendicular bisector of a chord segment AR, so it means AG is congruent to segment GR. So this is the symbol for the congruence. So AG is congruent to GR. So if GR is equal to 18, so it means segment AG is equal to 18. How about to solve for the segment AR? So let us see. Segment AR, so that is segment AG plus the segment GR. So the value of the segment AG is 18, and the value of segment GR is also 18. So it means the segment AR, 18 plus 18, that is equal to 36. So it means you need to add segment AG plus segment GR. So 18 plus 18, the answer is equal to 36. In circle B, segment BC is perpendicular to segment AR. In question number 2, if BR is equal to 30 centimeter, what is the measure of the segment BC, BA, and AD? So BR is equal to 30 centimeter. How to identify the segment BC and then the BA? What could be the solution? The solution, the radii of the same circle are congruent. So it means if segment BC is equal to 30 centimeter, so it means segment BC is also 30 centimeter. And then segment BA is also 30 centimeter. How about the segment AD? The solution is the diameter is equal to twice the radius. So segment AD is the diameter. So let us identify what could be the value of the AD. So twice of the radius. The radius is 30 centimeter. So that could be mean as 2 times 30. And 2 times 30, that is equal to 60 centimeter. So 30 plus 30, the answer is equal to 60 centimeter. In circle B, segment BC is perpendicular to segment AR. So let us see in question number 3. If segment AB is equal to positive 10 and segment BG is equal to positive 8, what could be the value of the segment AR? So this is segment AR. What is the solution? The solution, since segment BC, so this is BC, is perpendicular bisector of the triangle RBNA, so triangle B, G, and then R is a right triangle. So then, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for the segment AG. So the formula, segment AG is equal to the square root of segment AB squared minus the segment BG squared. Why minus? Because hypotenuse minus the legs. So the unknown is one of the legs. So what could be the value of the AB? So write segment AG. The value of the segment AB is equal to positive 10. The value of the segment BG is equal to positive 8. So let us solve. 10 times 10 is 100 minus 8 times 8 is 64. Segment AG, let us write, and then 100 minus 64, the answer is equal to positive 36. And then the square root of 36, that is segment AG, is equal to 6. So if we write, segment AG is equal to 6. Let us go back to the problem. Let us identify what could be the value of the segment AR. So the segment AR, so AG is equal to 6, and then GR is equal to 6. So it means the solution, 6 plus 6, the answer is equal to positive 12. So, paano nakuha yun? AR is equal to AG, that is 6 plus 6. And then 6 plus 6, the answer is equal to 12. So, segment AR is equal to 12. In circle B, segment BC is perpendicular to segment AR. So, let us solve number 4. If segment AB is equal to positive 6, so this is segment AB, and segment BR is equal to positive 8, what could be the value of the segment A and then R? So what could be the solution? The solution is, since ABR, so this is say ABR, is a triangle, then we can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for the segment AR. So let us solve. Segment AR, as you can see, in the illustration, that is the hypotenuse. So it means we need to add the two legs. So that is segment AB plus the segment BR. So the formula, segment AR is equal to the square root of segment AB squared plus the segment BR squared. The value of the AB is equal to 6. The value of the BR is equal to 8. So let us solve. 6 times 6 is 36. 8 times 8 is 64. So segment AR is equal to 36 plus 64, that is the square root of 100. And what could be the square root of 100? So it means the square root of 100, that is equal to positive 10. So the segment AR is equal to positive 10. Let us practice what you have learned about the relation among the chords of a circle. Instruction, given the circle B, provide the missing chords. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.